I certainly want to acknowledge all of the men and women of the cloth who are here today. It has been said before, but this is an inflection moment in our country's history. But ladies and gentlemen, it just took a video from a cell phone to awaken a wide swath of this country to the realities that many of you look like me. We've been fighting this battle for decades, indeed even centuries. The one thing I want to leave you with today, however, is when the protest over, as Reverend Granger alluded to, it seems the world has moved on. We need you, men and women of faith, to continue to fight for what is right. Now, we have to, through conversation, deliberation, define what victory looks like in this day and time. Come up with some actionable policies that we can lean on. But let me tell you something. As the chief elected official of the city, none of that happens without getting the right people in political leadership. So if there's one thing I will leave you with today, all this energy that we see out in the streets, all the anger and the frustration has to be converted into votes, ladies and gentlemen. Back in the 60s, folks were marching just so we would have the right to vote. None of that happened without the stroke of a pen of an elected official who said, "This shall be." So, as I leave you, work with your people, your followers, your congregations. We need to convert this energy into political victories in the fall, because all of this will be lost if we do not have the right political leadership. Thank you all very much. I applaud you. I appreciate you. I admire you. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.